In this tutorial, we are going to create a realistic water bottle in Blender. So let's get started. Okay, so here's our default scene. Let's press A and delete to delete everything. And let's add in an image for our reference. And you will get the reference image. Link is in the description. So let's go to image and let's add in a reference image. And I'll select my image. Okay, so this image is aligned to our view. So let's remove the rotation. So press Alt R. Now press R, X and 90 to rotate on the X axis on the 90 degree. So let's press 1 to go to front view mode and now let's bring this bottle in the center of our scene. Okay, just like that, and let's bring it down. So press G and Z. Okay, so now let's add in a cylinder. So go to mesh and a cylinder. Now let's turn on this X-ray mode to see what is going behind, so we can see both the image and our cylinder. So let's scale down our cylinder to the exact width of this bottle. So let's scale it down. So press S to scale down. And let's move it upward. So press G and Z. Okay, so now let's go to edit mode and let's select edges. So now let's create this bottom part of this bottle. So this is a beginner tutorial, that's why I'll make it very simple. So let's select all of these below edges and press Ctrl B and bevel, and let's bevel it something until right here, and let's scroll to increase the segments. So I think this is fine. Now let's select these top edges and let's move them all the way up. So press G and Z to move them upwards. Okay, so until something this. Okay, so now let's add in some loop cuts for our bottle. So let's add in a loop cut until right here, and let's add in another one until right here. Now let's add in a loop cut in the middle and let's scale those edges. So press S to scale, and now press Ctrl B to bevel them, and let's again add in a loop cut here. And let's add in a loop cut in the middle and let's scale them and press Ctrl B to bevel, and we'll repeat this process until we complete all of these ripples on our bottle. Okay, so now let's select these top edges and let's extrude them according to this reference image. So E and Z to extrude on the Z axis. Now S to scale down. Now press E to extrude again on the Z axis, and S to scale down, and let's extrude again and scale down, and let's extrude one more time. And now let's create this outer part, which is I don't know what is that, but it is near the neck of the bottle. So let's extrude again and just a little bit. Now let's extrude one more time until right here. Now let's extrude just a little bit until right here, and let's extrude all the way up until the cap. Okay, so now let's go to solid view mode and let's see. Okay, so our bottle is well modeled, not very perfect, but it is according to your preference on how good you want to make it. Okay, so now let's shade it smooth. So right click and shade smooth. Now let's go to this green icon, I don't know what is it, and let's go to normals and turn on auto smooth. Now let's create this outer part of this bottle which I don't know what is it. So press 1 and hold Alt and click to select the whole edge loop, but we want faces. So hold Alt and left click to select all of these faces. Now press Alt E and extrude along normals. Okay, until right here. Now again hold Alt and left click and press Alt E and extrude along normals, like that. Okay, now let's add in a bevel modifier. So bevel, okay, and increase the segments and shade it smooth. Now let's create the bottle cap of this bottle. So press 1 to go to front view mode and turn on X-ray, and let's bring the 3D cursor here. So hold shift and right click to to add in our 3D cursor. Now let's add in another cylinder. And let's scale it all the way down. Do some tweaking, okay, just like that. And let's go to edit mode. And let's add in two edge loops until here. Okay, now let's select faces, select mode, and let's select faces. So alt and left click to select all of the faces by loop, and press alt T to extrude along normals. And this time we are extruding it not on the outside but inside, just a little bit. Okay, now let's select these edges and press Ctrl B to bevel, and let's decrease the segments and here also. Okay, so now let's go to solid view mode and let's move our cap on top of our bottle, and it is great. So let's shade it smooth, and let's go to this green icon and turn on auto smooth. Now our modeling is done. Now let's add in water for our bottle. So let's hide this image and let's add in a mesh and a plane, and press 1 to go to front view mode, and let's add the plane for our ground and as to scale all the way up. Okay, now let's go to shading tab, but first let's change the render to cycles. And now let's go to rendered view and let's go to shading tab. Let's turn on rendered view and just check this scene world, and it will use the Hdri from the shading tab. Now we can create our water. So let's go to layout mode and let's go to solid mode and let's select our bottle. First let's hide this bottle cap and select our bottle, and let's go to edit mode. Now turn on x-ray again and press 1 to go to front view mode, and just select the faces of the bottle, because water can take shape of anything. So in this case it is our bottle, so it is up to you on how much you want the water to be filled. So I will select something until right here. Okay, now press shift D to duplicate, and now if you right click it will decline the position, and if you now press P it will separate it, and just separate it by selection. And now these copied faces are now totally a different object. Now let's go to front view again, and let's select our cylinder and just scale it down just a little bit. Okay, just like that. And let's go to rendered view and in the shading tab. Now let's change the material of this plastic bottle. So let's create new, and now we have to blend the transparent BSDF and the transmission value of the principal BSDF. So let's increase the transmission value of this principal BSDF and let's decrease the roughness all the way up. Now you can see that our bottle is looking like it is just made up of glass. So now let's move this away and let's add in a transparent BSDF. And now let's add in a mix shader and let's plug this transparent BSDF into the shader 2. And let's see, now let's turn on denoising and let's set the start sample to 10 so it won't slow down. Now let's see if our bottle is looking good. So now let's hide our water. So now our bottle is looking pretty much like plastic, but if we increase the transparent value you can see that it is looking like plastic. So I think a value of 0.7 is pretty good. So 0.7. Okay, now our plastic bottle is done. I think I should decrease it to 0.65. Okay, not bad. And I think now everything is fine. Now let's create the material for our water. So let's unhide our water and hide our bottle. But first let's go to edit mode select this and go to edit mode, and let's fill this face of the bottle. So let's go to solid view and alt left click and press F to fill. Okay, now let's go to render view again and let's add in a material for our water. So water material is pretty simple, just increase the transmission value, decrease the roughness value. Okay, decrease the roughness value, and now we have to just increase the transmission roughness of this material. So I think let's go to shading view and now let's see the roughness amount. Okay, so I think 0.3 is fine. Let's see. And also we have to see that if it is differing from the bottle. So let's see. Okay, so now the water and the bottle are looking totally different, and this is what we want. Now let's go to layout tab and let's uncheck this scene world again here, and now let's unhide our bottle cap and let's change this bottle cap material. So let's go to shading view and let's add in a bump node here. So search bump and let's plug the normal into the normal. Now let's go to shading view and now let's add in a wave texture and let's plug this factor into the height of the bump. And now as you can see that we have many wavy form of pattern on our bottle cap, and which is what we want. And we are plugging it into the bump, into the normal, because we want some kind of bumpiness in our bottle cap. So let's increase the scale all the way up. So I think 20 is fine. Now let's add in some sort of distortion, and now you can see that we have some issues right here. So let's press Ctrl T and don't forget to turn on the node wrangler add-on. Now let's set that from generated to UV, and now it has fixed the problem. Now let's increase the scale all the way up, and now our issue is fixed. Now let's add in some surface imperfections on our bottle, and in this case some surface imperfections are the roughness or the condensation of the bottle. So let's add in a noise texture and let's plug this factor into the roughness. And now as you can see, we have some sort of roughness on our bottle, which in this case looks like condensation. So let's add in a color ramp node and plug it in between. And now let's increase the scale of the noise texture. Okay, and let's increase the detail and roughness just a little bit, and let's drag this black value to make it a bit smoother. Now let's drag this white value to make it rough, and now we want the roughness on only some specific parts of our bottle. So let's see how it is looking. Okay, now as you can see, we are having the feel of condensation of water. Now let's set up our scene for rendering. Now let's go to solid view mode and now let's add in an HDRI. So go to world and click this yellow dot on the color and select environment texture. Now you can add any HDRI. The HDRI I am using will be in the link in the description. And now let's go to rendered view and let's uncheck this scene world. And now we have added our own custom HDRI, but first let's add in our camera. So let's set our scene just like this and let's add in a camera. Now to move camera to the view, press Ctrl Alt and 0. Now let's rotate our HDRI, but first let's turn on render region to only render this camera frame. Now let's rotate our HDRI. So go to shading tab and go to world and just select this image texture and press Ctrl T and just uncheck this scene world and go to camera view. Now let's increase the Z rotation. Okay, now let's increase the strength of this HDRI. So let's set the strength to 2. Now we have a much brighter scene. Now let's select our plane and let's change its material. So hit new and let's add in a bump node and plug it into the normal, and let's add in a muscular texture and let's plug it into the height. Now let's go to shading tab, shading view, and let's increase the scale of this muscular texture and let's increase the detail, and let's decrease the dimension and increase the luminosity. And now let's see how it's looking. Okay, pretty good. Let's increase the roughness all the way up and change the base color to a bit of sand color. Okay, so now I think now it's looking pretty good. Now it's time for rendering, so let's go to render settings. And you can change the device from CPU to GPU, but I know that most of us can't afford a GPU. So to encourage you, I am using CPU. And let's change the sample count to 1000. And I think the settings are pretty much okay. But let's change the color management and let's change the look to medium high contrast or high contrast as per your choice. But I will use medium high contrast. Let's press F12 to render and I will see you after some time. Okay, so that's it guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, hit that like button and consider subscribing for more great content. And I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.